Over 70% of the world's cocoa beans are grown in Africa, yet shipped out to process into bar or drinking chocolate. Stephen believed he would change this pattern and make the harvested cocoa grown in Uganda turned into chocolate from Uganda. With a cocoa plantation in Mukono, inherited from his family, Stephen sought to make a difference.
Where we are right now is where we've set up a new factory where we'll be producing chocolate, drinking chocolate, and cocoa butter.
He researched about chocolate making and invented a company, Pink Foods, in 2011 and started processing chocolate in 2014.
Well, I registered the company in 2011, then embarked on research and development to find out exactly what really comes out of the cocoa that my grandparents grew, that my dad expanded, that the country is exporting out of the country. So in our research, we discovered that indeed chocolate, drinking chocolate and cocoa butter comes out of this cocoa. And in 2014, we had our first product coming out at an exhibition for the youth in Lugogo.
Stephen now prides in taking farmers out of poverty who were getting terrible prices from cocoa in the market. He guarantees better price for the farmers' cocoa throughout the year. Now working with over 3,000 cocoa producers, he is also helping the farmer groups involved register themselves as cooperatives. He also prides in being the first person and a Ugandan at that to make chocolate in the country. A lot of the chocolate on the shelves of Kampala's major supermarkets come from foreign countries such as England, Denmark, Switzerland, Belgium, Brazil and Turkey, among others. A 100-gram bag normally sells for about 20,000 shillings, or approximately about $5. But now selling Ugandan-made chocolate branded Uganda to majorly Kampala restaurants and hotels who use it for desserts and ice cream. He has one appreciation for the Ugandan chocolate, selling a 50-gram bar at 5,000 Uganda shillings, or approximately $1. The chocolate's branded Uganda and the Pearl of Africa has also created jobs right along the supply chain.
Pink Foods at the farm where we operate at our plantation, we have 35 workers and 35 permanent workers and about 15 who come in at the times of harvest. Then in our production section, where we're currently making 30 kilos of chocolate per day, we have about 10 people we're employing.
Stephen learned to make the delicious, rich brown liquid chocolate through trial and error, largely challenged by starting the project with no background of chocolate making and a challenge of financing. Currently, Stephen has invested shillings 500 million into the machinery alone and creates jobs for over 30 people at the processing plant and 20 at the farm. He eyes expanding into the international market, but first intends to invest in the machinery required to meet demand. With a production of 30 kilograms or 12,000 bars of chocolate per day, Stephen reaps millions from his chocolate and is honored so far to be recognized by Forbes amongst the under 30 African entrepreneurs.
So I'm a honorary for Forbes magazine Under 30 Africa. Secondly, I'm also blessed that among the 40 million Ugandans, I'm the pioneer in chocolate making in Uganda and in the region at large.
To him, there is more to reap from sweet chocolate. Report by Sarah Chisache for Urban TV.